regarding the structure of the universe, the great Vedic text Srimad Bhagavatam describes that there are 14 planetary systems in this universe, and they are lying one above the other. Now, I am going to tell about these different planetary systems, these 14 planetary systems. As you can see in this figure, in the middle there is Bhuloka. This is the earthly planetary system where we are residing. Above the Bhuloka is the Bhubar Loka. Above Bhubar Loka there is Swar Loka or Swarga Loka. Above that is the Mahar Loka. Above Mahar Loka is the Jana Loka. Above Jana Loka is the Tapa Loka. And the topmost planetary system where Lord Brahma is residing, who is the first engineer of the universe, he is residing in the Satya Loka. In the Swar Loka or Swarga Loka, the different demigods like Indra, Chandra, Varun, they are residing. In the Jana Loka, Tapa Loka, Mahar Loka, in these planetary systems, great sages, ascetics are residing. Below the Bhuloka, that is the earthly planetary system, there are 7 lokas or planetary systems. First, below Bhuloka is Atala. Below Atala is the Bitala, then Sutala, then Talatala, then Mahatala, then Rasatala, and the lowest planetary system is Patala. So, the living entities are residing in all these planetary systems. The Martya Loka, the earthly planes, are situated in the middle. You can see that Bhuloka, half of Bhuvar Loka and half of Atala. These are the earthly planes, the middle planetary systems. Above is the Swarga Loka, the heavenly planes. These are the above the Bhuloka. And below the Bhuloka, below the earthly planes are the Patal Loka or the hellish planets. So, it is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, Tetam bhuktva swarga lokam visalam khine punye marta lokam vishanti evam trayi dharmam anuprapanna gata gatam kama kama labhante. The translation is that after having enjoyed the vast heavenly realm, when their merit is exhausted, they enter the earthly plane once again. Thus, those following the religion of the three Vedas, desiring material pleasure, obtain a reward that comes and goes. Actually, it means that people have a desire to go to the Swarga Loka and enjoy. There is opportunity of tremendous sense enjoyment in the Swarga Loka. There are apsaras, there are beautiful apsaras, there are beautiful gardens. One can enjoy sex life in the upper heavenly planetary systems. But the problem is that when the credit of pious activities is finished, then they have to again come back to the earthly planes. For example, when one goes to a shopping mall, he can buy a very costly watch, he can buy many, many costly things. But when the money in the pocket is ended, he has to again come back to his home. So, Swarga Loka, this is not the ultimate place to go. Because in Swarga Loka also there is birth, old age, disease and death. There is suffering in Swarga Loka also. and it is not permanent. We cannot stay in Swargaloka permanently. Whenever our pious credits are over, then we have to again come back to the earthly planes. So the opportunity is given to enjoy against our pious credits. So in all these 14 planetary systems, in the lower planetary systems there is suffering, in the higher planetary systems there is material enjoyment, but these middle planetary systems, especially Bhuloka, it is most conducive for doing spiritual activities. To remember the Supreme Lord Krishna, take His holy names, chant His holy names, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. One can practice spiritual life very nicely in this Bhuloka, that is the earthly planes. And this human form of life is the only species in which one can practice spiritual life, and he can go completely relieved, he can be completely relieved from this cycle of birth and death, and he can go to the spiritual world, which is far, far above Swargaloka. Hare Krishna.